Okay, here we go. Another Linux out of the box, and this is Fedora 42. So Fedora is a sort of upstream version, a version based on Red Hat. And obviously the hat, the Fedora is a hat, Red Hat. It just sort of works, doesn't it? Anyway, this is the machine as usual, RX 9960 XT, reasonably modern computer. Fedora is sort of pitched at modern computers. It's got a really nice website. I'm installing the which version? The KDE version, which is a better interface for me. The GNOME one sort of just don't get on with. And yeah, so how I'm doing these tests, it's basically I just download the ISO, put it on a USB stick, and try and install it on the system. And as you can see, there's plenty of other ones. We'll have a bit of fun with Endeavor OS in another video. I think it defeated me, Endeavor. So in here, I'll go down to it in a minute. We'll find Fedora and it's the KDE version, and we'll install it. Now, one of the things is if it goes wrong with these installations, that's the end of the video, because this is going to happen to you. If you're a Windows user or a Mac user, you're coming over to Linux, and this is basically how things work. Now, it may not go wrong for you. It may not. I mean, look at the Ubuntu video I did. It's 2.5 minutes long because Ubuntu just didn't want to work on this machine, and that was the end of it. So that's how this works. So it's literally, I don't tweak it. I just follow everything through like you would with Windows or Mac install or normal install. Just see what happens. So here we go. So we're booting up into Fedora. And obviously with all of these, you'll notice it's not like Windows. Windows just does a complete installation. There's no middle bit, is there? And so does Mac. I mean, with these, you get like this live version from a USB and you can sort of fiddle with it and have a look at it before you actually decide to install it, which is interesting. I don't know why Windows doesn't do something like that. So yeah, so welcome to Fedora Linux. Nice graphics. Not sure what is that background. KDE, which is this interface, which is nice. And a dragon thing. Thought it was all penguins. Anyway, there may be penguins, but maybe not in this one. It's dragons. Anyway, so yeah, this, I don't know the name of this installer. It's called like Calamaris or something, or Ubiquiti or something. Anyway, it's, if you do install a lot of Linux distributions like I do, you'd have seen this before. Yeah, so reclaim the space, delete the old thing. I've got another video, 22x04, where I try to install AMD. Yeah, so I'm going to put a root user on here. I mean, as I said in another video, why don't they just call it admin? That would be great, and we will know what we're talking about then. And that's admin, you add admin privileges, which was basically root, so why can't you just call it admin? Maybe they're missing something. Maybe. Anyway, yeah, so I tried to install AMD GPU drivers directly from AMD onto, and followed every step they gave me on the website to do this, and just killed my computer. Anyway, that's a whole other video. So I guess we're going to install. And yeah, so it's live, so you can have a look around. So what we've got stuff on there already. Multimedia, mail, they can see mail, games, Minds, but it's got Office. Yay. Office Write is already on there. So your WordPress needs are pretty much taken care of from the get-go with Fedora. It's interesting, certain installations, some of the other Linux installations, they come really bare bones. And you have to add bits afterwards. So some of them give you a full package. Some of them give you an idea in the installer, whether you want to put the Office stuff on or leave it straight off. So it's up to you. But this obviously comes pre-installed there. This is quite quick. So I may not speed this up if you're okay. I may just carry on rambling on about Linux whilst this is going on. So yeah, so I've been doing a lot of these. As you can see, follow this, like a whole list of these that I've gone through. And it was all about, you know, download the ISO. Everybody's raving about Linux. Is it good for games and stuff like that? Just install it. And what I normally do is install OBS, see if we can get that working. Install Steam, play a game, and basically just see, you know, as a normal user, and try not to go into command line. Because if you're a Windows user or a Mac user, the amount of times you've gone into command line terminal, or it is terminal on the other one as well, you can count one hand as a normal user. I mean, I've been using Macs for years and you just don't do it. I mean, you do if you're doing, you know, AI and weird bits and bobs, but you don't normally do it. Windows, no, I don't think you do either really, unless you've, normally if it's broken, you go in there. But Linux, it's sort of, you know, if they can get Linux to this bit where you don't have to do command line, I think it will sort of help. And I think the other big takeaway from all these videos I've been doing is all they need to do on these platforms is give people a really easy way to install programs, like from the store. There's some great OSs out there, like CatchOS is really good, really good. But the way that you install software, it is just literally medieval. It's like it literally looks like a DOS box, where you look at some of the other Linux installations and the way that they're doing, like Bazaar, it's got this bizarre store. It's brilliant, beautiful laid out. And I mean, a lot of them, what else has got a good store? Yeah, I mean, the Flatpak stores, the app stores, they're really nice. And it's something you're used to coming from Windows or a Mac. So catchy, you know, those sort of things can get. Because catchy, I'll tell you, the best ones so far have sort of been CatchOS and Bazaar. They hands down sort of win. They can do all the basic bits and bobs, and they can do a lot. I mean, so this has got a lot to live up to. And basically, Bazaar is based off of Fedora, but in a very different way. I need to get rid of that background. Anyway, let's do a reboot and see what's happened. Now, normally with these, I'll restart and there'll be a mass of updates to do. So it depends. Some of the installers pull updates from the internet as you install. Some don't. Some do offline installs, so they literally only install what they've got. And then when you do a reboot, there's a massive update to do. So it's like Windows. If you're a friend of Windows, then the updates you're about to do are pretty standard. So it's going to come back, hopefully. Here we go. And we're back. And that's gone. And we're in. Quite snappy. It's obviously detected my graphics card okay. I had a bit of problems with that. Some of the older installs can't do it. Anyway, so what have we got? Let's have a look. Something's going to come up, isn't it? Something's going to pop up and say you need to update. But let's have a quick look around before we get pounced on by the update police. Dolphin Discover. That's the store to download software, is Discover. And also it sort of does updates. Okay, let's just do Writer. Let's get that out of the way. First test. Yeah, boom. Done. Okay, we can type words. System. What else have we got? Oh, and there it is. Update. Let's have a look at these updates. What have we got to do? Fetching updates. So I think, yes, this is Discover. This is like the store part, where in here you'd have, you know, I think we'll click through it in a little bit. You can, you know, get software, all sorts. And what's that? Repositories. Don't know what that is. Well, you get repositories on other OSs, but it's just not as plain as that. What's that? Steam? Do I have to click that on later? Google Chrome. There's absolutely no indication about what you should be ticking here. That's really handy. Okay. 5.1 gig. I think the installer's not even that big. That's a lot of updates. That is a lot of updates. All right, let's get that going. Update all. Jesus, that is a lot. Okay, yeah. I don't know whether I should fast forward this. Let's do a restart. Restart, come on, you can do it. Oh, click. Yeah. That's a lot of updates. I think this came out in April. What are we in now? April, May, June, July, August. Yeah, so that's 4 months worth of updates on this. And they don't update the ISO. Finally, let's get rid of that wallpaper. I don't know why I get a lot of flack over that. I just don't like it. It just looks like a child's thing. And there we are. I don't fear that, but it's like, it's the future now. It's not, I don't know. It's probably very famous. And I'm insulting some amazingly huge artist. Right, okay. Developers tools. Yeah, these are all install stuff. So tab through here, find whatever you want to install. That's pretty standard. Yeah, pretty standard. Tab through. Come on, I mean, I've got like 200 meg internet. So that's a lot. 5.1 gig of downloads and updates. I think what was the biggest one? That might have been Nobara, but I've forgiven Nobara because Nobara is actually pretty good. That had 1,500 updates or something to do. But Nobara is good. I mean, have a look on the channel. There's a load of these I've been doing. And they've all got pros and cons, these. Some of them are just atrocious because you know, they just can't, you can't install them. And they pitch themselves, or they've just overpitched themselves for what they are. And I mean, it's sort of, but they're all useful. They're all Linux in a shape or form, but it depends on how you can, you know, use it. I mean, I can use all three operating systems quite, you know, really well, but I always try and have to sit here as if I'm a Windows user, what would I want to do? If I'm a Mac user, you know, I'm spoon-fed, I click things and things download and install. And if a Mac goes wrong with a code thing, which is quite rare, actually, you know, you just lost. Windows, yeah, we're used to that just blue screening and crashing and all that kind of stuff and not starting up. I've got a Dell 8960 in the back, and that thing just randomly boots or not. It does its own thing. It's just become its own computer. After many times of installing different, this, you know, wiping it and reinstalling, doing all the plain drivers. Anyway, so let's restart this. And then hopefully when we do the patches, everything will come back. And then I'll put Steam on, and then I'll put OBS on, and then I'll attempt to install DaVinci Resolve on this. So a bit of a black screen coming up. Here we go. Downloading updates. So installing updates, not downloading updates. 28%. So it's doing, I'm going to speed this up, so bear with me. So with a miracle of editing, I'm sped this up 2,000 times. Here we go. Whizzing through. Took a while. And it's going to reboot. Here we go. Black screen. Okay, so we're rebooting. Here we come. BIOS. Let's just boot this back up. Yeah, so then we can install OBS and Steam. And then, here we go, Fedora. Spinning, black screen. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. That doesn't look very promising, does it? I feel we have a very short video ahead of you. So there you go. So what I've done is I've installed the ISO, gone through it. The ISO version worked fine. I've updated to the latest version and it's killed my computer. Now, there's probably, I'm going to do a reset now and reboot it and see if it does it again. But here's the thing. I'm not going to fiddle with this because, you know, that's a 9060 XT. It's been on the market for months. The 9000 card's been out for ages. That's a standard computer. If it doesn't work on first install, because Windows would, Mac would on a Mac, all the other Linux installations apart from Ubuntu did, I'm not even going to bother with it. And it's sort of going to make me go, oh, I would go back to Windows now, wouldn't I? Or whatever, I would be turned off from my Linux experience. So 16.15, I'm not going back to 16.14. I'm going to try that again. And if it fails again, then Fedora, you've lost your shot at the title, I'm afraid. You've lost your shot at the title. Yeah, black screen. So that's all she wrote. Fundamentally, that's Fedora done and dusted, I think. Failed installation. So make sure you don't have a 9060 XT or a Ryzen 9 chip or something like that. But I didn't do anything extraordinary here. I just did a straight install with the latest version. The latest ISO, I downloaded it yesterday. So yeah. Anyway, let's move on to another OS. Have a look. I've done bad. I've done loads. Anyway, thanks for enduring that, and no thanks to Fedora.